Welcome to Metal Gods TV.
Okay, this is Matt Hill from Metal Gods TV. We're here backstage, or on stage, with Dimmu Borgir, Silent Oz from Dimmu Borgir at Colchester Arts Centre. Silent Oz, welcome to the UK.
Thank you.
This is your second date, is it, with Brighton yesterday?
Yeah, my second UK date, fourth show of this tour. So.
And with the show, was it well received yesterday at Brighton?
That was great. It was awesome. It's good to come back and play some more UK dates, because usually on our European tours we only stick by London or Birmingham, you know. But now it's more extensive, so it's also cool to do like kind of smaller shows, at you know, club shows and stuff. So more intense.
A lot of small venues on the show, which is fantastic for the fans. I mean, get up and close and personal with Dimmu Borgir is fantastic. So is it nice for you as a band to play up close and personal with your fans?
Yeah, it's always great to be closer to the fans and the audience, because when you play, you know, like huge festivals, you don't get that connection. You know, you get the connection, but in a different way. So it's always cool to do the smaller venues.
And with this whole tour, it was based around voting on some albums. Basically, the fans had a chance to vote for their album they wanted played in its entirety. And Enthroned, Darkness Triumphant was the one that got voted in.
Yep.
Did you secretly have one you wanted to play, or were you happy with the way the fans went with the vote?
I mean, we kind of expected it to be an Enthroned album, because that's the one that really put Dimmu on the map, you know. Although we had two albums before that, it was the Enthroned, Darkness Triumphant that really made us known in the musical world. So I would be really surprised if it would have been another of the two other albums that but no, it's really cool to go back and revisit the older songs, you know, that you haven't played for a long time. Some of the songs have still been in the set, you know, but it's really cool to go back and try to figure out how you play the old songs. And that also reminds you of how you put songs together back in the day compared to now, you know. So it's a whole different way of writing songs for us now than it was back then.
And you as a musician, can you think back, do you have any early influences from other bands or other people for you personally when you think back?
Well, you know, we grew up with the 80s wave of metal, you know, and then later thrash metal and death and black metal. So we and that's stuff we still listen to and draw influence from, you know. Obviously, we don't want to copy our heroes, and you know, you want to make your own version. So I'm really. No, I'm really happy that we can incorporate still stuff that we grew up listening to. You know, you have bits and pieces here and there that you put into your own music. So,
yep. And you'll be back again for the UK next year. You're at Bloodstock. It was announced only last week, I think, that Dimmu Borgir at Bloodstock Festival. So look forward to coming back to UK next year.
Yeah, we look really forward to it, because we it was a few years ago we played Bloodstock, and we weren't too happy with how our equipment didn't work out at all. So we were forced to play on rented and borrowed equipment, and that really puts a downer on the show from the get-go. So. But hopefully we can make up for it this time, and big, cool gig, yeah, for sure.
And just one final thing, tonight's show, Dimmu Borgir sort of tends to sort of pull from inspiration lyrically from the dark side, everything else. Playing tonight in what was a church, does that give it some sort of a good, great atmosphere for tonight's show?
You know, it's not the first time we played in a church. It's probably been done like 10 times in our career, and as much as we try and get away from the church, it pulls us back in.
Love escape. Well, thank you for your time. I look forward to the show, and I'll be there. Everyone else, enjoy the show tonight. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Appreciate it.
May God have mercy on your soul.